Well, hello and welcome back to another exciting edition of Coffee with Stephen. So this week's blog is entitled simply Thanksgiving. Every year I write a Thanksgiving blog, I write a 4th of July blog, a Christmas blog. To be honest with you, I'm yet to write a Yom Kippur blog. I should probably consider doing that at some point in the future. But Thanksgiving is unique, and this particular Thanksgiving is very unique. Those of you who've been kind of following along at home with my family, you'll know that my older daughter Carolyn lives in London with her partner Alan. She's about to have a birthday in February. My younger daughter Chaney, obviously, we've talked about before, she's at West Point in New York, and she just turned 21. So for this year's Thanksgiving, we have decided to all travel to Las Vegas. Now, Las Vegas serves a couple of different purposes. Number one, it's someplace where we can all meet up. But number two, it happens to be the location that Sandy, myself, and Carolyn, as a 4-year-old, all decided to get married. Those of you who don't know, Carolyn is my adopted daughter. I inherited her when I married Sandy, and we went through the formal adoption process. So we really became an initial family at the Rio Hotel in Las Vegas back in 1995. Chaney would come around a couple of years later. But in the blog, I talk about Thanksgiving from a somewhat different perspective. We all get to make individual choices on how we perceive our life circumstances. We can choose to be negative about the trials and tribulations that are foisted upon us, or we can choose to be positive and look at all of the blessings that we enjoy. And even those trials and tribulations, interestingly enough, can also be blessings. They allow us to grow. They allow us to develop. I can tell you with some authority that my wife would tell you that I am certainly a far more mature version of myself than I was even a few years ago. So we do, in fact, mature. We do, in fact, get better. And the way we choose to perceive things is really the defining characteristic. And I reference Stoicism in the blog. It's not Stoicism per se. It's more of, honestly, it's more egotism. I mean, it's that we are the ones who get to make the choice of how we perceive our universe, not some external factor. Now, every year, we have this really unique holiday called Thanksgiving, where we are intended to purposefully choose to look at the positive. And that's all fitting. I mean, it's a good sort of reminder per se, but it's also an opportunity to really reflect on how we go throughout the entire year. I have so much to be thankful for. Of course, I have the most wonderful partner in the world, Sandy. I have two incredibly beautiful and talented children. And to be quite frank, I have you. Those of you who read the blog, who watch these videos, and who come in and train, you are the ones who help our society become continually better. You are the ones who actively look at the things that need to be improved in our society, both on an individual level as well as a societal one, and you take up the necessary burdens in order to achieve that. For that, myself, my wife, all of us here at Artemis, we are thankful for that. So again, enjoy your Thanksgiving. Know that I will be sitting at the blackjack table at the Venetian Hotel with my family, thoroughly enjoying the experience. As always, train constantly, train consistently, train repetitively, and train with purpose. Above all else, stay safe.